contribute to several hundred families in town, approximately 21,000 pounds of food. What we've seen is an overwhelming increasing demand. We expected there to be a lot of people reacting to this, and we're not surprised, but it certainly is eye-opening that towns especially, given we have a little bit different role during emergencies like this, but towns seem to be working with their local food pantries, with Foodlink, to provide this basic need to our residents. So this was really a pilot program. I don't want to call it that because it's going to be done on a larger scale, but we're very happy with how it worked today, and at the end of the day, we're just not patting ourselves on our back, but I'm glad that we were able to meet the need that was here, and I think it's eye-opening for us even more that we're going to be needing to do this for several weeks.
Right now, let's stay in place, let's think about how to take care of one another, and that's why I'm so grateful for all the work being done at the town level, the county level, the state level, with our partners in the federal government, and with our community-based organizations and healthcare systems. Monroe County has been a model, and one of the reasons for that has been the leadership of Adam Bello, and it's my great privilege to introduce the county executive, so he may say a few words.
We're facing right now something that's unprecedented, and I know there's a lot of concern in the community, a lot of anxiety, particularly around access to food. And I think one of the things that is important here is that everybody work together. I talk a lot about the fact that we all have a role to play. We all have a role. This is what makes Monroe County so special. And what's happening today is really why we're going to come out of this on the other side okay. We are going to be okay. And we'll get through this because we have such a caring group of folks around here, such caring nonprofit community, community-based organizations that are helping people every day.
What you're seeing is hundreds of residents from Irondequoit, low-income residents, vulnerable residents, receiving 50-pound boxes of food in a really controlled, safe, calm environment, and that's what we hope every emergency food distribution for the time being looks like. Again, every single day of the year, we have a network of hundreds of community-based organizations across the 10-county region who supply emergency food to families in need. Many of those agencies are still operating, they're still accessing food from Foodlink, and we're encouraging them to do so. In addition, we are building and supplying 10,000 boxes of emergency food supplies like you see here today. Core food items that can help sustain families. We are getting those out to our residents, again, across our region through our existing network of partners. These are emergency food agencies and nonprofits that do this day in and day out. And as long as they're able to, they're gonna continue to partner with us to do that. So we're working with 211 every single day, sometimes by the hour, to make sure they have updated information. And I want that message to